Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Thanks for joining me today. So today I am drawing a flamingo in color pencil using Faber-Castell Polychromos on Canson 1557 180 grams paper. And this is a piece that I did for Patreon. So the full 8-hour tutorial in real time is available on there. And when signing up, you also get instant access to tons of other projects to follow along with. So if you want to learn colored pencil or pastel drawing with me, have a look at the link in the description, and there you can find the tutorial library as well if you want to have a look at everything that's currently available. So let's get started right away. You'll see a snippet of the tutorial, so a real-time part of it, just a little part of drawing the feathers. So I hope you'll find it helpful, and let's get started. Okay, so that's good for now. Now I can continue with this area next to it. So that has to be lighter and more orangey toned. So I already did a little bit of a base layer with some, what was it? The cadmium orange, but I think I need to go in darker. And just map out these feathers a little more. So I'm going to go in with the dark cadmium orange, 115. And sketch out all the individual feathers, give them a bit of a base tone, just the same as I did with this first part. Okay. Just connecting that orange to the dark shadow. And again, making sure to leave a light border around each feather. So with pastels, this is easier because you can just fill in the whole feather right away. And then later on, go over with a lighter color to lighten up the edges. But with colored pencil, we can't do that. So we have to draw around the edges.
Okay, I'm just going to keep mapping out all these feathers. Though right here they become more pink and red again, so the orange is mostly here in this area. So I'm focusing my orange on this area for now. I'm working section by section to not lose sight of what I'm doing, because all these different feathers can be very distracting. So just keeping it slow, working section by section, and continue when one section is finished. So I'm now going to focus on this part. Okay, I'm going to add a tiny bit of pale granny malic to these feathers to darken them up a little. Just the base of them as well, just the area that is coming from underneath another feather. This way you get more dimension in the feathers as well. And then to fill up the gaps, I'm going to add pink again. First, a little bit of light magenta, and then also some of the brighter pink. I'm going to glaze this over everything, so also over the feathers themselves. Okay, so then I'm going to add a bit of light purple pink, 128. Also really works well with the orange to brighten it up. Thank you. Okay, I need more color, more depth in there. Add a bit more shadow on the feathers themselves. Make them look overlapping more. So I'm going to go back to the pale granium lake. Maybe I should do this one. Yeah, let's do light cadmium red. Let's get some more of that orange in. Now I can sharpen up the lines. Okay, let's do a little bit of burnishing, focusing on the edges of the feathers. Now I see that I can darken up this area some more. And I think I don't want to make it brighter, but I do want to darken it up. So I'm going to add some Venetian red. That is 190. All right, so let's continue with this. Working with the Pale Granium Lake 121 color now. I'm going to continue sketching out all these darker shapes that I see, darker feathers. I'm going to leave this area for what it is right now and then come back to it later. I'll have to continue a little bit. Focus on lightly mapping out all the dark centers of the feathers that I see. So on the back right here, you see some darker feathers. There are also many very light pinkish parts in between. So that I'm going to fill up with some base layering later, but I just want to make sure that I have all the dark areas mapped out. Just doing this lightly because I want to add some orange on top of these feathers as well. But I do see a reddish undertone in the darker feathers on the body, so that's why I start out with this pinkish red tone. So here we have some really large feathers. You can see that center line in between, that white line. So I'm not going to copy that, but I am going to try to get the same feel of that feather texture. So the most important thing is to have that shape in the back. So we have those feathers going up and around, and then here on the side they curve around the body. So that's very important. So that's what I want to put in with my first mapping out layers.
Alright, so that's it for today. So the rest of the feathers is just the same technique over and over again, so I didn't want to share too large of a part with you today. Just a little part so you can see how it's built up, and I hope you liked it. So if you enjoyed it, leave a comment below and don't forget to like the video, and then I will see you in the next one. Thank you so much for watching and thanks for your support.